All right, good Tuesday morning, everybody. It will be impacting us, Tropical Depression Cristobal, or the remnants of Cristobal. We will not be looking at any flooding anywhere near like that, nor any flooding at all. Some heavier downpours are certainly a possibility, though, later this evening, and perhaps as early as maybe 6, 7, 8 o'clock. We'll get to that projected radar in just a second. Grand Rapids on the tower cam. We've got good deal of sunshine. There are these high-level clouds that have been passing across ever since the open, and they will continue to do so, but allowing a decent amount of sunshine for the next several hours. So these temps, which are already to about 80 to 82 degrees, even 84 down to the south, Three Rivers, Benton Harbor, they will continue to ascend until they get to about 90 to 92 by, I'd say, 4 or 5 o'clock. At that point, the high clouds will be lowering into a thicker mid-level cloud deck, so we'll really be leveling off the mercury at that time, and then even start to slip a bit towards 6, 7 o'clock as clouds thicken even further and the chance for a shower or a thunderstorm comes about. Look at the southeast winds, though, starting to pick up here early this afternoon, 15 to 25. And then the gusts going to about 35 to 40, maybe even 45 miles per hour. Grand Rapids and Kalamazoo by later this evening. I say later this evening, maybe 9, 10 o'clock into the overnight. That would be the windiest of the times. And we do have a wind advisory for a portion of the viewing area. We'll get to that momentarily. Showers and thunderstorms, at least scattered variety coming about. And then another risk for perhaps some stronger storms by early to mid-afternoon tomorrow. We'll get to that radar with regards to that as well. And then much quieter once all that passes on through. We don't really have much of any consequential weather Thursday, Friday through the upcoming weekend and into early next week. This first L is Tropical Depression Cristobal. You know, I'll have to check on the exact circumstances from the National Hurricane Center. As of a couple hours ago, it was still listed as a tropical depression. Nonetheless, it's irrelevant whether it is or it isn't, because it's been holding together pretty well, lifting northward, and this warm front, which is more or less a demarcation line between the less humid air and much more humid air to the south, that is coming northward. And when it comes in here, you're going to know it by, say, 5, 6 o'clock and thereafter tonight, because the dew points, which are now in the mid to upper 50s, those will scoot into the upper 60s and a much more tropical feel as this chance for a few thunderstorms comes about. Southeast winds around 10 miles per hour. Look at these winds, though, by later this evening. This is on the timestamp at 11:30 tonight, and the sustained winds in the white, the gusts just above that, and these winds will be out of the southeast to south at that point and gusting to around 40 miles per hour in Holland and Muskegon. We may have some gusts, folks, to about 50 to 55 miles per hour. Muskegon County northward into Oceana County for the overnight period. Here we are with that wind advisory. Actually does include Ottawa County as well. So by the advisory, we can include that portion just to the west of Grand Rapids. But I think the strongest of the winds, Muskegon and northward, for this overnight period. Future track model doesn't have a whole lot going on through 3, 4 o'clock. By the time we get to 5, 6 o'clock, certainly there could be a pop-up shower or thunderstorm towards Berrien, Cass, St. Joseph counties, and then that'll lift northward. So some heavier downpours, tropical-like downpours, can be experienced with this, well, tropical depression Cristobal lifting northward, and even into the early overnight there may be some thunder showers around and some gustier ones as well. That's what we've got to look out for, folks. We're on the right side of a tropical system, right, not right or wrong, but right versus left, and that can oftentimes be the spot where you can get a little bit more wind shear in the atmosphere and perhaps contributing to a stronger or severe storm. But by tomorrow afternoon, a second disturbance rides in, and check this out, by 2-3 o'clock tomorrow, we're getting some of these pop-up kind of cellular storms with a very atmosphere laden to produce perhaps some severe weather. The focus right now looks to be over towards the Detroit area, but I'll tell you what, we got to look out for that. There could be some severe weather here early to mid-afternoon tomorrow. You can see where the Storm Prediction Center has it outlined, the main focus towards the central portions of the state and eastward. But that may actually get pushed a little bit more towards Grand Rapids and Kalamazoo. We got to see how this plays out on Wednesday. We've got disturbance number one, Cristobal, today, and the second one riding in quickly into a very moist air mass tomorrow, Alyssa. So a couple different chances for thunderstorms, and then not much going on through the weekend.
Thanks, Anthony. Well.